Welcome to bilingual e-lectures for diploma students on linear integrated circuits. This is my 21st lecture on IC regulators. See, for diploma students for electronics and communication engineering in the linear integrated circuit syllabus, regulator IC is also dealt. So, let us cut short some of the points related to regulators and we will be discussing here. See, discussing about the transistor based regulator circuit is not the scope here. So, our scope of discussion here is a IC regulators, right. So, the regulator circuit available in the form of monolithic IC. When you come in the final semester, when you do the projects, you will be using this IC, you will be depending this IC for your power supply. So, in our previous module, I explained very clearly what is regulators, right. So, once again let me introduce why do we need regulators, right. See, basically from this diagram we understand that in our power supply circuit, you have a four basic important circuits, sub circuits, right. We are using say for example, you let us consider the charger, what you are using to charge your cell phone. So, there are let us consider the DC power supply used for any application for that matter. See, in the circuit, the input is AC, right, the output is perfect regulated DC, right. So, the AC input voltage is first given to the transformer. So, what is the need of the transformer here? It reduces the magnitude of your amplitude of your AC voltage to the required DC level voltage. That is, transformer converts your high level AC input to the low level AC input. That means, how much DC output you require here. For example, suppose you require 5 volt DC and your input voltage is 230 volt AC. So, first it is the input 230 volt AC should be lowered to the 5 volt AC, right. So, transformer can give accept AC and can give output also in AC form. So, it gives you, now you get here 5 volt AC. This, to convert this into a DC, you need a rectifier. So, rectifier converts AC into DC. Most often here you will be using a bridge rectifier, right, and with more than 80% efficiency, both input, both positive and negative half cycles will be converted into a DC, but it is a pulsating DC. That means, of course, at the output of rectifier, there is no, the voltage is in only one direction in the positive, but amplitude is changing, varying, that is pulsating, right. So, that you have to convert it into a DC by means of filter port, we are creating the almost constant voltage here, right. But regulator, what it do is, it regulator is a circuit required here. So, whenever there is a sudden changes in the power supply input occurs, that should not affect the output voltage. So, during, even though the input voltage changes, the output should be remains constant, supply change, okay. Similarly, at the load side also, whenever the load change also should not affect the output voltage. For this, we have the circuit called the regulator, which keeps the output voltage constant irrespective of changes in the supply voltage as well as load conditions. So, in the regulator circuit you would have studied in your earlier classes using the transistors, right. So, this is available in the form of IC, the monolithic IC form it is available. So, that is what the scope of our discussion in this module. So, regulator vandu enna mariyana regulators la enna la IC is available for giving you the positive voltage and negative voltages and variable voltage. So, different type of voltage regulator IC we are going to discuss in this module. There are two types of voltage regulator, fixed voltage regulators and adjustable voltage regulators. What is fixed voltage regulator? The output voltage is fixed, right. That is the IC name itself, it will reflect. See, the fixed voltage regulators, there are two kind of fixed voltage regulators available in the market. They are positive fixed voltage regulator and negative fixed voltage regulator. Positive fixed voltage regulator, right, and negative fixed output voltage regulator. So, rendu type of fixed voltage regulator irukku, positive negative. So, how to identify that? Most often 78 series, 78XX, 78 in start pandra IC number vandu positive voltage regulator, 79XX means it may be any number here, that is negative voltage regulator, right. 78 nu aarambikkirathu positive voltage regulator, 79 IC number, if it starts with 79 it is negative voltage regulator. 78 positive voltage regulator, the XX ingirathu the number in this place decides the output to value of the output voltage. See, for example, if it is 7805, then it is the voltage regulator IC giving positive voltage 5 volt, fixed 5 volt will be the output, right. So, similarly, there are so many ICs are available in this series to give the different output voltage. Similarly, in the negative output voltage also, there are number of series of ICs to give the different value of output voltages. What is adjustable voltage regulator? So, here at the output, this IC is also available to give you positive as well as negative output voltage. Positive voltage as well as negative voltage also you can create using this kind of IC. Also, it is adjustable. You can change the output value by varying it, by connecting the variable capacitor to this IC. For example, the adjustable, one of the adjustable voltage regulator is LM317. Manufactured by National Semiconductors Company, and negative adjustable voltage regulator is LM337. Also, another kind of voltage regulator called switching voltage regulator. So, National Semiconductors manufacturing the switching voltage regulator LM1723. So, we will be discussing these ICs in our coming module. So, what is the internal circuitry of IC regulator? So, any IC regulator, it does have a little bit complex internal circuitry. So, one of the block diagram of the IC regulator is shown here. This is one of the simple internal circuitry of the IC regulator, IC. See here, your input voltage is given to the, actually in this kind of regulator IC you have only 3 pins, one is input pin, another is output pin, the center pin is the common pin, ground pin. Okay. So, this is how the pins have been arranged in the IC, first pin, center pin, last pin. Most often center pin is a common pin, ground pin, and first may be the input and third one may be the output pin. So, in this fashion these 3 pins are arranged, right. Now, look at this circuit, you have a series pass transistor here and thermal shutdown and current limiting circuitry and comparator. Also, you have a voltage divider circuit. So now see what is happening here inside. Simple feedback is here. So your input voltage is given to the pass transistor. Why it is called pass transistor? This voltage is passing through this transistor based on some conditions, right? That condition is put here through feedback. What is feedback? The output voltage is fed back into the, not in with input voltage, it is output voltage is used to control, right, for the control purpose. So see here, you have a comparator here and the series volt, here you have a voltage divider circuit, simple voltage divider circuit, okay. So the output voltage is divided by these two resistances, divided by the ratio of these two resistances, and it is given to the inverting input of comparator, that is negative input of the comparator, right. What about the positive input? It is ground, it is here at the positive input of the comparator, we are connecting the reference voltage, right, reference voltage. Now, what will happen? The potential at this point, inverting input, whenever it is greater than the V reference voltage, so the output of the comparator is negative saturation. Whenever it is lesser than the reference voltage, the output is in positive saturation. Simple comparator, many times we have discussed in our earlier modules, right. So, the comparator output is given to the thermal shutdown and current limiting circuit. What is it? See, okay, it has three terminal. Once again, let us repeat, the IC regulator, three terminal, one of the terminal is the input terminal, V input, the output terminal referred as, indicated as V output, and common terminal, okay. Simply, it has three pins, one for input, one for ground, one for another for output. So, the block diagram, as I discussed in the previous slide, it is a part of the output voltage is taken with the help of potential divider formed by R 1 and R 2. Output voltage or potential divider mulama, R 1 R 2 mulama divide panni and the potential to compare with the reference voltage. Okay. This is compared with the reference voltage. V reference is the internally generated using Zener diode. So, this reference voltage is internally generated using a Zener diode. How to generate the reference voltage using Zener diode? Zener diode reference voltage eppadi generate pannuvaanga? In the reverse bias. We know that Zener diode, when you reverse bias, it maintains the voltage, right. Only current increases through the resistance while the potential is fixed when it is reverse biased, right. So, that is how the reference voltage is being obtained here. So, reference voltage on the Zener divider mulama in the adathala create pannirukom. Inge potential divider mulama output voltage divide panni inverting input terminal kudukurom, non-inverting terminal ku reference voltage kudukurom. After comparison, a control signal is generated and it is applied through productive circuit. What is productive circuit here? Thermal production. What for it is required? Edhukku theva? Through this circuit, it is given to the series pass transistor working as a control element. So, your pass transistor is thus a control element through which the input voltage is regulated, in fact, to available at the output voltage. Whenever the change occurs, sudden changes occurs, so pass transistor only used to control or regulate the variations, right. And the thermal production circuit, whenever the potential voltage changes occurs with respect to the temperature conditions of in which the IC is used. My IC, what a environmental temperature also may shift, it may also shift the, introduce the variations at the output voltage. So, that is also taken into the consideration by means of the circuit. So, what are the advantages of IC regulators? It is very easy to use. Of course, if you construct the digital, if you construct the discrete regulator circuit using a transistor, size is big, consumes more power, and reliability is less. So, of course, it has the advantages of IC. So when you go, for the monolithic IC, it is very easy to use, simple to connect. But this more regulator IC, it has only 3 pins, so it is very to use, easy to use. One input pin, one ground pin, one output pin. Okay, so it greatly simplifies the power supply design. So you don't need to bother about the regulator circuit at all, which is there inside the IC, right? So as a diploma students, it is easy for you to use this IC in your project work. Whenever you need for your project, definitely you will be requiring a power supply, whatever the project it may be. You have to give the supply, right? DC supply. So whenever you need DC supply from the AC input, you have to use the at the output of the supply, you have to use the regulator. So you can simply select the IC regulator, whatever depends on the whatever voltage you require. It regulate the IC regulators are small in size, thus overall size of the power supply can be reduced. Yes, since you are using the IC, you are selecting the IC, it greatly simplifies the power supply design, because you don't need to bother about the internal circuitry. Simply the IC you are having with 3 pins, okay, size is also reduced, overall size of the power supply is reduced, because your IC size is very small with 3 pins. Cost is very less, IC regulators are versatile, and they are provided with features like built-in production, programmable output, current voltage boosting, internal short circuit, current limiting. So these are the some of the products, circuitry, sub-circuitry it requires to improve the performance of the IC regulators. They are all available within the IC. So it is better to simply select the IC for your regulation purpose, right? You don't need to construct the discrete circuit for the regulation. Now, so in the block diagram of IC regulator, the output is divided by the voltage divider network and compared with the reference voltage, and comparator output is given to the through the production circuit, it is given to the series pass transistor. To this control signal, adjust the control element in such a way that the output voltage remains constant. That is, the comparator output through the productive circuit given to the control element. What is control element? Series pass transistor. What it do? அது என்ன பண்ணுது? சச் ஏ இட் கண்ட்ரோல்ஸ் தி அவுட்புட் வோல்டேஜ் ரிமைன்ஸ் கான்ஸ்டன்ட். ஓகே, இட் கண்ட்ரோல்ஸ் ஆர் இட் அட்ஜஸ்ட் தி டிவைஸ் இன் சச் வே தட் த அவுட்புட் வோல்டேஜ் ரிமைன்ஸ் கான்ஸ்டன்ட் இரஸ்பெக்டிவ் ஆஃப் சேஞ்சஸ் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் இன் தி சப்ளை சைட் அஸ் வெல் அஸ் இன் த லோட் சைட். தெர்மல் ஷட் டவுன் மீன்ஸ் தட் த ஐசி சிப் வில் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்கலி டேர்ன் இட் செல்ஃப் ஆஃப் இன் த இன்டர்னல் டெம்பரேச்சர் எக்ஸீட்ஸ் டிபிகலி 170 டிகிரி செல்சியஸ். See, for example, every regulator IC, if you go through its data sheet, you will find the data related to its temperature. That is thermal shutdown temperature. That means it automatically turns it off when the internal temperature exceeds this particular temperature. For example, if your IC withstanding temperature is 175 degrees Celsius, whenever the internal temperature exceeds this, it will go to shutdown. That means it stops working. The current limiting circuit will protect the chip from the excessive load current. Because of thermal shutdown and current limiting, the IC voltage regulator chip is almost indestructible. Of course, this also you have to consider, the current limiting circuit will protect the chip from excessive load current. So inside, I said there are some of the sub circuitry. One of the circuit is current limiting circuit, okay, which protects the chip from excessive current, excessive load current. So whenever the load current, whenever the changes occurs in the load current beyond the maximum limit, so this limiting circuit inside the chip will come into the picture and protects the circuit, protects the regulator. See, the most important point when you use the IC regulator, you need a capacitors. எதுக்கு capacitor தேவை? What for you need capacitor? The capacitor is required if the regulator is located at an appreciable distance from filter. The output capacitor improves the transient response of the regulator. Yes, right? So the transient changes occurs whenever the changes occurs in the supply side as well as in the load side. To remove that effect, we need a capacitor in our regulator circuitry. The capacitor also reduces the noise present at the output. The difference between the V in and V out, that is of the input voltage and the output voltage, V in minus V naught. The difference between the input and output voltage is called the dropout voltage, okay, and must be typically 2 volt to 3 volt for proper operation of the regulator. So, it should be limited within this value, your dropout voltage, okay. So, that is how the internal circuitry is designed. The IC regulators can supply load current from 100 milliampere to 5 ampere. So, minimum 100 milliampere, maximum 5 ampere of your load current. So, how to connect these capacitors in a regulator like this? See, simply your IC regulator have 3 pins, pin number 1, pin number 2, pin number 3. Pin number 1 is an input pin, input unregulated voltage is connected here and regulated output voltage is available at the pin number 2. But the pin number 1 is connected to the ground through a Cin, input capacitance, capacitor. Similarly, at the output also we have a capacitor between the output terminal and the ground here. So, this capacitor used to eliminate the noise present as well as it is used to maintain the situation like transient changes, right. So, what is the value of the capacitor, how to choose? So, this is also the another important factor. So, if you purchase a regulator, the regulator IC, whenever you connect the regulator IC, you need 2 capacitors. Now, see what are the regulator ICs available. Earlier we have seen 2 different type of regulators, positive type fixed voltage regulator and negative fixed voltage regulator in terms of in the fixed voltage regulator is concerned, okay. I already told you positive fixed voltage regulator starts by the number 78 series are all giving you the positive fixed voltage. So, what are the different ICs available in the market in the positive fixed voltage range? 7805 gives you the 5 voltage. I told you, know this 78 refers to the positive fixed voltage, the number refers to the indicate that the output voltage is positive fixed. This 2 number XX, it is given here the general name XX, that means these numbers can be there in the place of XX, it may be 0506. So, that this refers to the actual output voltage. 7805 means positive 5 volt, it gives you the plus 5 volt output. 7806 gives you the plus 6 volt output. 7808 8 volt. 7809 9 volt and 7810 10 volt, 7812 12 volt, 7815 15 volt, 7818 and 7824. Up to 24 voltage DC to generate the to give you the fixed output DC 24 voltage, you have the IC in the market 7824. So, from so in the positive fixed voltage minimum 5 volt to maximum 24 volt to generate, you have the ICs available in the market. Where this 24 voltage DC and all will be required, most often in our circuit, you will be requiring the DC plus 5 volt or 6 volt. Suppose when you are using the, whenever in the operational amplifier circuit, you will be requiring plus as well as minus. So, you will be requiring a voltage, it may require a plus 10, plus 12, plus 15 and all. Okay, but what about 24 volt in some applications like PLC and all, 24 volt DLC is most common in PLC, programmable logic controller, it may require the power supply up to plus 24 volt DC, there you can these kind of ICs will be required 7824. So, the features are 3 terminal input ground output and high output current typically 1.5 ampere. Short circuit current is 750 milliampere to 5 volt. These are the specifications available in the data sheet, right. You only have to understand the meaning of the specification, right. and the internal thermal overload production is circuit is there inside, and low quiescent current may be 6 milliampere. Maximum input voltage you can apply is 35 volt, minimum input voltage may be plus 2.5 volt, something like that. Okay. So, this is some of the specifications of the positive voltage regulator series, right. So, once you understand this specification, you will be carefully, you can carefully use this IC in your circuitry, right. So, most importantly, you have to know that what is the maximum input voltage you have to give and what is the short circuit limit current and so on, right. So, this is your LM7805 IC. So, this positive fixed 5 voltage, it gives you the positive fixed 5 voltage. These kind of ICs are being manufactured by many manufacturers. So, this LM code refers to the manufacturer name National Semiconductor, right. So, this is how most often the, so here is the pins 1, 2, 3, pin number 1 input, 2 ground, 3 output. So, the now let us see the specification of the LM7805, National Semiconductor 7805 regulator. So, input voltage range may be 7 volt to 35 volt, current rating may be 1 ampere and output voltage V max, that is actually it is a fixed voltage, right. It should be a fixed voltage, you can fix it in between these two range 4.8 to 5.2. IC provides for 7805 5 volt DC regulated supply, it should be a 5 volt only, output is always 5 volt, but heat generated is nothing, is equal to input voltage minus 5 into output current. This is how you can estimate the amount of heat generated. So, what is the solution for the heat generated? There will be a heat sink. So, most often all the IC regulators are manufactured with heat sink to, for what? To reduce the heat. Okay. What is heat sink? Right. This kind of metal are provided to reduce the, to distribute the heat. So, if you have a system with input 15 volt and output current required 5 ampere, we have the power consumption is estimated like this 5 watt. So, appropriate heat sink is chosen to reduce the, to reduce the heat. So, 5 watt energy is being wasted as a heat, this 5 watt is calculated like this. So, this much energy is being wasted as heat, so you have to disperse it. So, 79 IC is the another type of regulator, fixed voltage regulator, gives you the negative voltage, right. And quite often this is being used with the op-amp IC. A simple and reliable solution to providing the negative output voltage is 79 voltage series voltage regulator. Okay. So, when you construct the operational amplifier circuit, you will be requiring both plus voltage as well as minus voltage. So, you may require 78 series IC as well as 79 series IC also. Suppose, if you require plus 12 volt minus 12 volt, you can choose 78 12 and 79 12. Right. The capacitors connected at the input and output are used for providing additional filtering. Okay, noise, to filter the noise. So, 79XX IC regulator available in these ranges 79.02.05, 79.05.5, 5.0 and 79.06, 79.08, 12, 15, 18 and 24. So, what does it mean? Whenever we say 79, that means output is minus negative voltage, right. So, 79.12 IC gives you the minus 12 volt DC. Now, let me conclude that simply we have discussed what are the IC regulators and what is positive voltage regulators, fixed positive voltage regulator, what is fixed negative voltage regulator, 78 series, 79 series of ICs, right. So, let us continue our discussion in the next module. Thank you.